Hi, I'm Sandy Mall, and welcome to Patents TV, Episode 71. I'm the Southeast Coordinator, and today I've brought a couple of robot friends with me. I've got Dot and Dash. I'm going to introduce Dot to you right now. Hi, Dot.
Welcome to Episode 71 of Patents TV.
Well, thank you, Dot. Dot can do a lot of things. Dot can do things right out of the box without any programming, or we can get into some of the programming of him. What do you think about that, Dot? I'll take that as a yes. Let's do something where you aren't in the iPad and I just talk to you. One of my favorite things to do is carry you around the office and... How about now? Will you be a lightsaber? So Dot can be used by anybody just to be a lightsaber. And who doesn't want a lightsaber? Another thing Dot can do is be a magic 8-ball. I love the magic 8-ball. In my classroom, I'd always make my students ask the magic 8-ball their bathroom questions and things like that, whenever there was a yes or no question that I had to answer. So let's ask Dot a yes or no question. Okay, Dot, are you going to behave for me?
And the answer is... I'm going to go with maybe.
That's about right. We always have to plan for that with technology. I think I'm done with you for now, Dot. Thank you for playing.
And the answer is...
All right, let's look at Dot's bigger brother or sister. This is Dash. Dash does a lot of things. I'm gonna let Dash say hello to you too. And I'm using the Go program from Wonder Labs. Once you buy the actual robots themselves, all the programs are free that come with them. They're just free to download. As of right now, who knows where they're going to go in the future, but right now everything that they've got is free. So I programmed Dash to say a couple of things for us, but first I have to turn him on, and I'm going to have to tell the iPad that I've changed robots. So I'm going to push the plus sign up there. We're searching for robots, and they found Dash. So I need to tell him that Dash is here and we need to connect him. All right. Hi, Dash.
Hi, I'm Dash. I'm going to teach you all about programming.
Well, cool. What else have you got to tell us?
Let's take a look at some of the apps you can use with me on the iPad.
Excellent.
This app is called the Go app. I can tell you things or even read you a story on it.
That's right. If I had a book, I could actually program through those bottom numbers, and they go on for a long way. I could program into those numbers like every page as we go on and have Dash read the story to a student. Of course, you have to record that yourself. I'm going to move him around a little bit with the motion app so we can see how he moves. I'm not very good at this. So if I just wanted to play with him for fun, moving him around the room, I could do that. And I do like to do that. You got anything else to tell us, Dash? Oh, come on, there's something, isn't there?
Since I have my xylophone on, why don't we go to the Xylo app and I'll play you a song?
That sounds like a good idea. Let me get out of this app then.
Interesting.
Okay, I'm again going to make sure that it knows it's connected to Dash, and it already did. When you first do this app, you want to kind of go through it and make sure that you're all keyed up here. So I'm going to go through setup and calibration. We've got Dash on a flat surface, and I've got his xylophone stuff on. And so let's position him for key number one, so we have a pretty song. Good deal. That's working. Then position him for key number 5. That's better. And position him for his final key here. See, I try and get it in the middle so we get the best tone. Very good. All right. Are you ready to play us a song, Dash? Which song do you want to play? How about Up on the Housetop, because it is December. In here, you can actually create all of your own songs by putting a new song, and then you would just kind of empty song. Oh, there it is. And create a new song. And you do that simply by touching what keys you want. When. Okay. So I've got that. And I think I'm done. I don't want to do anything with that. And then down on the bottom, it says you can do motion or no motion. I'm going to do some motion on this. I want him to just roll forward a little bit. So let's see what I've got now. All right. Good job, Dash. You want to play something you already know? So Dash can be my own little marching band. Let's go back and do Up on the Housetop. And I've already set him up for this. So are you ready, Dash? Very nice. Thank you so much. Dot and Dash are programmable from the lowest level, easiest things you can do, all the way up to really, really hard programming levels. It's all about getting kids interested in doing code in schools for your STEM and your STEAM classrooms. And Dot and Dash are very UDL friendly in that they have so many different ways that they can interact with children at all sorts of different levels. Well, that's all for Dot and Dash. I want to show you something else that is also multi-level and very UDL friendly. So now I want to show you some apps associated with another tool. This tool is called the Osmo. And the Osmo is for the iPad. And it again is like Dot and Dash in that you buy the hardware, which is the base unit. So it's got a base that fits any kind of iPad you have, even an iPad mini. And it's got this reflection thing right here that just takes the camera and reflects the camera down to the tabletop. And I'll kind of discuss, well, you'll see in a second why that's important. I'd also like to introduce Andrea. Andrea is the Southeast and Northeast Regional Assistant. And she's going to help me with Osmo, because one of the great things about the Osmo is you can use it with more than one person. So if you're one of those teachers who has an iPad in their classroom and more kids than iPads, this is a great tool. The Osmo does a lot of things. We're going to start with numbers. And Andrea, numbers is the newest one, isn't it?
That's right. It came out pretty recently, only a couple months ago. It was so popular right off the bat that it was actually back-ordered.
Wow. Okay. So we're going to start playing with the numbers Osmo. So Andrea's going to set us up
into counting. So we'll be using the little dice-like
chips. Okay. And it says welcome. Really, I don't have any sound going on this. We're up a little further. We started with ones and twos and threes all the way up to 11, and now explain how this thing works.
So the idea is that you have to use the little chips to make one of the total numbers that is up on the screen, preferably one of the ones down already touching the water.
Cool.
So I will make a 16 with three fives and a one piece.
And it's not timed, and I love that, because I was one of those kids who could never get my times tables or any math done really fast.
Yeah. So it's all at your own pace. You can take your time counting out the little dots that are located on the chips.
So is it actually reading those? That's what it does, right?
It does. It actually reads from the reflector in the play space what the chip is saying. So it will see whatever you play up there, even if it's wrong.
Okay, so it's adding, oops, so it's adding it up. And there's no 7, so I know I got to keep going. 12, that's going to be a good one.
And you get points for every bubble that you burst or every bubble that you don't burst by that doesn't turn into water that fills up the basin. Once you get to this to the middle of the screen, that's when the game is over.
Okay. So that's the math. And it goes, how far does that go up? Can we see what it does?
Well, yes, we can. This can go up, it goes from counting to adding to connecting to multiplication tables.
Osmo can do a lot of other things too. It can do tangrams or tangrams. I always say that incorrectly. It can do, tell us about a couple of these other ones and then we'll get to the word one.
It can also do Newton. It will actually show what you have on here, and if you had a blank piece of paper, you would be able to use the lines that you create. And then these little balls would fall down from the top, and then your aim is to get them to here. Of course, it's not going to work because we're on wood grain. There's also Masterpiece, which is used for drawing or tracing. It's one of the more popular apps that the Osmo has seen, because you always see something like this on Pinterest. So you would choose a picture, it'll turn it into line art, and then you trace this by looking at the screen with your finger or your pencil or a pen or a marker, and you can color these things. It's sort of like making your own coloring pages.
Cool. All right.
Now on to words.
On to words. Okay, I got to warn you. When we play words, it gets a little competitive. Okay.
So words comes with the little chips with little letters on them.
And again, the Osmo is going to read those
through the reflector. I'm going to start a new game.
I better clear the decks here.
I know. I've already knocked down numbers. Don't want to knock down anything else. We're going to play versus. And now we have to figure out the blank slots for this word. And there's
Let's
a picture
find our
of
letters.
A panda, so I'm really hoping that it's a panda.
Oh.
And I got two. And she got two that time, so we both get 4 points.
So it's keeping score on either side. It tells us clear the table. Ooh.
Trying really hard to find these things.
So we can't talk and do this at the same time.
Obviously not, so I will let her win this one. But what it's doing is it's seeing these tiles, and it doesn't matter which order you put the tiles in, as long as you find the correct letters that actually go into the word. So this can be helpful with vocabulary, spelling. It can be good for vocab words, like in math or in science.
What about like word wall words? Could I put my own words in there?
Yes, you could. Actually, you can use this and download and make your own albums, and then use these albums that here are downloadable content. And say you wanted to do rocks and minerals, you have uploaded your own rocks and minerals section, and now you can play on different levels, easy, medium, and then extreme, and lock
we'll do an
that
extreme.
In.
Oh.
We're doing extreme?
Doing extreme.
Oh,
let's
okay.
see.
And then we'll lock it in.
Oh, I know what that is. It's your favorite.
It's.
Oh, no.
It's a conglomerate.
Oh, yeah, it's conglomerate. It's not just garnet, it's conglomerate.
It's conglomerate. So this, even though we are being on a versus version of this, we could actually be working together to figure out all of these vocab words.
Yeah, or you could take pictures of family members and put their names underneath there. There's just so many uses for this. Again, a very UDL tool. It can be used cooperatively, it can be used competitively. It's a nice way to get tactile, you know, and some bigger motions with your arms and letters and numbers and an iPad.